Welcome to Analytics with Nags. We have reached the end of this playlist, that is Power BI Paginated Reports, where the last topic I'm going to cover is embedding your paginated reports. We have seen paginated reports deployment into services and how you can share it. And in some cases, we want the paginated reports or any reports, we want to embed that report in our websites or our internal portals. How we can do that? That is what we are going to see as part of this video. Let's try to check it out. What are the options? You will get a URL or iframe to embed your Power BI paginated reports. These options same like Power BI reports. In addition to that, in paginated reports, you will get a link. Let us try to talk about all these things as part of the demo. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So I'm in Power BI service and let me go through the report. So here I need to provide a parameter. So let us provide the parameter name. Once I choose that, I will get a simple report over here. So where is the embedding option? It will be under file menu, where you have an option called embed. So in the embed, you got two things. One is like this URL, that is http://app.powerbi.com, that is RDL embed, right? So this is one of the URL you will get to use it as part of your embed procedure. So, and another option is iframe. This is most commonly used nowadays, right? You kill the iframe, and where you will use this code, single piece of code, to embed in your HTML or whatever website language you are building, you can embed those. So these are the two options. And another option is like generate link. What is this generate link? Basically, this generate link is used when you have dynamically wants to configure some of your reports, right? To filter based on the input parameter you need to pass some from your external application based on different department. Assuming this report is filtered for the department, you need to pass that department, and this report should internally filter and show it to them, right? Such a things you can do it using this particular URL, right? So what I'm trying to convey is like, now you see the category is accessories. Instead of this, let me copy this code and put it under over here, okay? Once I press that, it will again show me accessories data by default. It will not prompt me to choose the parameter as it did before. Now, instead of that, I will go and choose the category as formal. Okay, we know the formal exists in our data. Let us try to view it, right? So I need to press enter, formal, and press enter. Once you press that, the data you can see from here, it is filtered for formal, and you can see the results here. So instead of choosing the data over here and directly, you can customize this URL based on your requirement. I hope you enjoyed the entire playlist related to paginated reports. You understand how to create it, how you can share, and also you can embed these reports in your websites. This is the end of this playlist, and if there are any new videos comes up in my mind, I'll definitely upload as part of this playlist. Keep watching this channel for more updates. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.